What's up, internet? I am Manish from rebellionrider.com and I'm back once again with another awesome Python tutorial. Today's tutorial is going to be about another string method of Python language, which is endswith. Now that we have learned how to check if a string starts with a specified substring or not in the last tutorial, it's time to move on and learn how to find out if a string ends with a specified string or not. But before that, please do not leave without pressing that thumbs up button if you like the video. Also, this year I am aiming for 1 lakh subscribers. So please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Now let's start. After starts with, the second string method in the list of Python programming is ends with. As the name suggests, using this function we can determine if a string is ending with a specified substring or not. Let's take a quick look at the syntax of this string method, endswith. The syntax is pretty much the same as the previous string function starts with. The method endswith also accepts three parameters. Let's take a look at those. Substring. The first parameter is the substring. This is the string that will be searched in the main string. This is the only mandatory parameter in the list. Start IDX. The second parameter is the start index. Here you have to specify an integer value which will indicate the index number from where the interpreter will start the search of the substring. This is an optional parameter, which means if you want, you can skip it. In case you do not mention the start index, then interpreter will start the search from the index 0, which is the default value. And IDX. The third parameter is the end index. Similar to start index, here also you have to mention an integer value. This value will specify the index number on which the interpreter should stop the search. Once again, this is an optional parameter. In case you do not mention any value here, then the interpreter will keep searching until the main string ends. That's all about the syntax. Now let's do some examples and learn how this string method endswith works in Python. Similar to the last Python tutorial, here also I will do three examples demonstrating each of the three parameters of the function which we just discussed. In the last tutorial, we used the command prompt for the demonstration, but today our choice of editor will be Atom. So let's start. In order to perform a search, we will need a string. This string works as a base string onto which the string method endswith will perform the search. So for today, our base string will be with rebellionrider.com, I will be the master of Python in no time. Here we have the base string. Next, we will search if this string or a part of it ends with a substring or not. To do that, we will use the endswith string method of Python. In the first example, we will see if this string ends with the word time or not. Here, I created a variable my underscore str and saved our base string into it. Next, using this variable, we will call the string method endswith. Let's see how. Here, I first wrote the name of the variable which is holding the base string onto which we want to perform the search. Followed by that, I have a dot operator and then the name of our method endswith. As you can see, here we have supplied only one parameter to this method, which is the search string. On execution, the interpreter will start searching the entire string and see if it ends with the specified search string, which in our case is time. If the base string ends with the search string, then it will return true, otherwise it will return false. Let's execute and see the result. So the program executes without any error, but where is the result? Unlike command line interface, where the function call directly shows the result, in editor like Atom, we need to take help of print function to display the result back to the user. To do that, we have two ways. In the first one, we can create another variable and store the result produced by the function call into it. Then using print function, we can display the value stored into that variable. The second way is that we can directly place the function call into the print function. That way, we don't have to declare an extra variable. I guess the second one will be much nicer. Let's go with that. Now, if we execute the code, we will see the output. Here we go. The output is true. Now, let's do the next example. Let's say I don't want the interpreter to start the search from the beginning of the string. Rather, I want it to start the search from index number 39. That way, we can save time and resources. So, what do I have to do for that? In order to start the search from a specific index, we need to mention the index number as the second parameter of the endswith function call, like this. Simply, right after the search string, put a comma and then write the index number from where you want the interpreter to start the search. In my case, it's 39. Let's modify this function call a little bit more. Let's say this time I want the search to start from index 39 and end at index 55. Also, instead of time, let's see if the string ends with the word Python or not. In this function call, we have used all the three parameters. Let's execute and see the result. The result is true. So, that's how we use endswith string method in Python. Hope you enjoyed watching. Please hit that thumbs up button and like the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.